So, Josh, one of the big themes, and I don't know if we hear it quite as much, maybe just over the past week or two, but certainly one of the most persistent themes that we heard over the course of certainly in the primary, but then in the for the large extent of the general, was that Hillary Clinton had a problem with young folks. The millennials were just not buying it, and in many ways, that's completely wrong.
As is often the case with pundits' narratives, right? So, you know, I called up Gary Jacobson, who's a political scientist at University of California, San Diego. He studies millennials' political preferences. And the first thing he said is, this is what we're seeing is a very small reversion to the mean. So traditionally, voters who are 18 to 34, they turn out at very low rates. They're hard to organize. And what happened was that this guy named Barack Obama came along, and he was a unique candidate. He was young and fresh and the first black candidate. He spoke their language, and they turned out in record numbers for him. But then, you know, Hillary Clinton is, if nothing else, a traditional Democratic candidate. And what we're seeing is a very modest drop-off in the number of young voters who say that they're going to vote compared to Obama's two campaigns. So if you look at the Harvard IOP poll, which is kind of considered the gold standard of young people, polling of young people, 48% of 18 to 34-year-olds say they're definitely going to vote in November, next week. And that would be a drop-off of 1% compared to 2012 and a drop-off of about 5% compared to 2008. But it would still be a bigger turnout than the youth vote in any of the four previous elections.
Wow. Okay. So, I mean, it's not even it's created a new mean, if you will, as opposed to reverting to one, right?
Well, that is right. I mean, it's one of a number of things that have been kind of, it's been a fairly structurally consistent race. So, people have to fill column inches. We've heard a lot about white working class voters and, you know, Trumpers in the Midwest who are being ignored by coastal elites and we're not having enough empathy for them. That was one of them. And then the other one has been this idea that the millennials are tuned out and they hate everybody and that they're not going to vote for Clinton. Meanwhile, if you look at Clinton's margin over Donald Trump among those who say that they will vote, in some polls it's even greater than Obama's margin over Mitt Romney.
Now, that is, I mean, there's so many paradoxes about this election, right? Like, I mean, the idea that we're reverting to some type of typical structural election when we have a figure like Donald Trump as one of the candidates is shocking in and of itself. But this idea that those millennials who are paying attention, who are motivated to come vote, I mean, tell us about the implications of this, right? I mean, the idea that Hillary Clinton will not only be maintaining a margin that Barack Obama scored over Mitt Romney, but expanding it. What are the implications, not just in terms of this election, but down the road?
Well, so Jacobson did this study, and political scientists talk about something called generational imprinting. It turns out that our partisan preferences are kind of a mishmash of what we inherit from our parents and what our social peer groups think. And one of those influences that's really key is what's going on in the political universe when you come of age politically. This is usually, you know, it varies from individual to individual, but say in your early 20s, for most people, you start paying closer attention, you start being more knowledgeable about the parties and the candidates, and it has a long-term impact on one's partisanship for the rest of their lives. And there are things that can shake that up. You can have a major depression or something like a Watergate, or you know, something. There are things that can, external shocks that can change the pattern. But for the most part, what we see is this clear generational pattern where certain generations, when they come of age, you can look at the people who turned 20-ish during Reagan's era. They skew very Republican. And
present company accepted, I got to tell you. But be that as it may.
Yeah, me too. But what we've seen is this increasing divergence of young people as they come of age, a partisan skew toward the Democrats. It started during Bill Clinton's presidency. We started to see young voters coming of age and favoring the Democrats by a little bit. Then we get George W. Bush's disastrous presidency, and that margin increases. And now you're seeing a group of people coming of age at a time that is, you know, we don't need to rehash the Bush presidency, but that group skewed more Democratic. Then Obama came along, and we see this very, very Democratic group of young voters. So, you know, if Hillary Clinton were to win, and you see if the economic recovery continues apace, you might see 40 years of people coming of age at a time when the landscape is conducive to a more democratic outlook, a more liberal outlook. And then when you drill down, you know, you see that younger voters in the Obama age are much more progressive on just a whole range of issues. And one of the interesting things is that younger Republicans are much more liberal on immigration, same-sex marriage, health care reform, abortion. They care about the environment. They're much more likely to believe the scientific consensus of climate change, and they're much less likely to consume conservative media like Fox News. So this is a generation that could really kind of reshape American politics in the future.
That's interesting. I mean, restate it just so that I'm clear. You have a partisan label that you subscribe to, but within that partisan label, the Democrats, those who voted Democratic in the Obama elections, are more to the left than, say, people in our generation would have been when they voted for Walter Mondale, let's say, broadly speaking. And on the Republican side, it's the people who voted for Mitt Romney would actually be to the left, and these are, you know, young people, left of the people who voted for Ronald Reagan.
Yes, but I have to go just a little bit deeper in the weeds, because some of this change, not all of it, but some of it, is that the younger generations, each age cohort, becomes more ethnically diverse. You get a smaller share of white people in those cohorts. So if you look among white Democratic voters, the young ones are actually slightly less liberal than white Democratic voters of an earlier generation. So what you're saying is right, but it gets a little more complex when you start looking at the cross-cutting differences in ethnicity and race.
That's even more fascinating. You don't have that same granular assessment on the Republican side, because they're not terribly diverse to begin with. So we're seeing the Republican younger voters get white Republican voters, and presumably most Republican voters getting more liberal, whereas the white Democratic voters are just slightly less liberal than their counterparts. But broadly speaking, because of demographic changes as a whole, that cohort, that age cohort, is getting more liberal. All right, we got to take a break.
You said that much better than I did.
Well, I mean, I had no idea about it. You just explained it to me. We've got to take
Let me just add one thing. Because they're less likely, well, probably because they're less likely to consume conservative media, they also have less stuff like Obama is a Muslim.
which is, I mean, in, arguably what conservatism has become,
It's interesting to see the shift in the Republican young people, especially.
Josh, let's take a quick break here. When we come back, I want to talk about this because one of the things that interests me when we look at that partisanship is there going to be, or whether or not you think there might be a material difference in the nature of these new Democrats and Republicans? Because we've just had an election where there's been virtually issue-free in many respects. We got to take a quick break. Sam Cedar, Ring of Fire Radio. We'll be right back after this.